You will never get a software engineering job with coding projects. Now, I know you heard that and think it's the craziest bar ever, but you just gotta hear me out for a sec. There are a lot of you who have already been down the coding rabbit hole where you guys build a lot of fun coding projects. And when I say fun coding projects, I mean to-do lists, weather apps, calculators, things like that. And while these are still great projects, like these are some really great CRUD projects, especially for beginners, the truth is you are not going to get the job with projects like these. Even with intermediate coding projects like Netflix clones, YouTube clones, things of these nature, you are not going to get the job with projects like these too, because let's just be real, you probably just copy and pasted that code from a coding ASMR video. Don't worry, we've all been there. Here's the thing, as coding gets more and more accessible, more people are starting to learn to code. Everyone, and I mean everyone, is jumping in on it. I mean, you don't believe me? Just look at this.
This thing, it just increments the count by one.
It's pretty basic, but I like the UI, like the buttons, the colors and everything.
Yeah, that's our chat.
And while it's awesome because people are realizing how lucrative this space is, but with more people definitely comes more competition. If you're competing against millions of to-do lists, weather apps, calculators, what's gonna make you stand out? So, if coding projects don't get you the job, what does? It's simple, creating startups. Now, before you roll your eyes and think startups, no, that's for entrepreneurs, not me. That's not for me. You gotta just hear me out for a second. Just hear me out. By startups, I don't necessarily mean you gotta make the next Amazon, the next Uber, the next Instagram. What I'm talking about is creating impactful projects, tools, solutions, platforms that solve real problems for real people. When you're working on a coding project like that, you're not only showcasing your coding skills to a potential employer, you're showing your employers that you can think critically, solve problems, and create something meaningful. And to be honest, it's incredibly lucrative. Why? Because one of two things are gonna happen. One, you start a wildly successful business and you become the next Jeff Bezos. Or two, you end up with a genuinely impressive project that you can put on your resume and your portfolio. And it's really just a win-win situation for you. Okay, now you're probably wondering, but Jamil, how do I create a startup? Let me break it down for you. The first step is to think. Yes, you need to think about three things. The first one being, what is something that you personally are passionate about? Two, what do your family, your friends, anyone around you, what do they do for fun, to kill time, as a hobby, for work? Three, and what is something that you want to do for work? These questions help you tap into areas where you already have knowledge or some interest. Now, once you have some ideas from those questions, it's time for you to look for problems in any of those areas. Here's an example. When I was growing up, my dad always struggled with paperwork. Sometimes it was scattered everywhere and it was super hard to keep organized. Now, if I wanted to create a startup, I would think of a tool specifically for working class dads to help them keep their paperwork organized. And that would be my niche, solving a problem for a specific group of people. And boom, just like that, I have a startup idea. But here's the thing. This is a problem with a lot of coders. Ideas are only half of the battle. A startup isn't just the idea. It's the solution that you create. And that's where your skills as a software engineer comes in. Your job is to create digital solutions for everyday problems. And that's what makes our field so impactful. And no, you don't need a huge team or some venture capital funding. It could be something as simple as building a web application or an application on someone's phone, even an automation script that solves the problem. So why does startups and impactful projects work better than basic coding projects? Well, to be honest, that sentence should tell you itself, but here is a list of three reasons why. First one being, they show that you as a developer has initiative. Employers love to see that you've built something completely from scratch that solves real problems. Number two, it helps you stand out. While everyone is showcasing their to-dos, their weathers, their calculators, you are showcasing a project that you actually took time to think about and to engineer. It makes you stand out as a real software engineer. Number three, they teach you more, way more. Building something impactful forces you to learn technologies and learn things that you're not comfortable learning. You would have to go out and find a lot of the information yourself. You would have to force yourself to build it, and it's not going to be easy, but it gets the job done. And that's what separates someone who knows how to code and someone who's truly hireable. So with all of that being said, here's what I want you to do. Sit down and brainstorm. Think about the three questions I mentioned earlier. Write down 5 to 10 problems that either you or people around you face on an everyday basis, and then choose one that excites you and start working on a solution to fix it. And here's the key here. Remember, it does not need to be perfect at all. It could be the most hoodwinked project ever, as long as it's a project that you took your time to figure out a solution and it semi works. That's what we're looking for. It does not need to be perfect. So start small, test your ideas out, and just iterate. So here is the big takeaway. While beginner coding projects are a great way to learn how to code and it's amazing for beginners, it will not necessarily get you the job. What will get you the job and potentially so much more is creating impactful startups and solutions that make a difference. So stop making calculators and start making a change. Now, if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe and comment your startup idea. I would love to hear what kind of projects you guys are working on. And who knows, you might even inspire someone else.